Right, good morning, you lovely people. Welcome along to Wednesday, the 15th of July, 2020. Getting nearer and nearer my holiday, and I'm excited. Yes, it's under 60 days till I actually go to Blackpool. Well, yesterday was eventful. The shopping slot that we had with Asda's was between 7 and 9. Now, I didn't expect him to turn up at 9 o'clock. Well, he did. Bang on 9 o'clock. He had two substitutes. We ordered sweet chili chicken fries and they gave us drumsticks, so they went back. Given their due, they've already issued the refund. It was only £2.50, but every penny counts. I can't remember what the other one was, but I accepted it anyway. Well, as advertised yesterday and today, face masks are going to become compulsory in shops and supermarkets as from the 24th, which is next Friday. So we've been on the shopping channel, Amazon, again today, and we've ordered some more face masks. Now, I should have checked the dates because they're not going to turn up until the 25th of August. The pandemic will have been and gone by then. I don't know. Well, it wasn't bad. Three masks, tenner. Yeah, I've got a tartan one and the girls have got butterfly masks, so not that bad. Right, as our friend Chris Reardon announced this morning, Wetherspoons are going to be slashing the prices off their beer. Yes, VAT is being knocked down from 20% to 5%. So it's basically a good 12% off your pint of beer. Not sure what that is in price because I don't go to the pub. I don't agree with the pubs. Do you like my t-shirt? I don't need Google. My wife, hold on, I've got to lift it up. My wife knows everything. Probably right. Right, as barbecue weather is fast approaching, because we're meant to have a spike in the weather very soon, I want to know how you make your potato salad. Do you cheat and buy it from the shop? Or do you make it? We make ours. And a little tip. Boil the potatoes, lightly salted. Then we add a bit of mayonnaise, a bit of salad cream, and a teaspoon of whole grain mustard. You can put chilli flakes in it as well, because Eric's wife, Suzanne, she makes a wicked potato salad. Probably the best I've ever tasted. But we put whole grain mustard in ours. Please comment below and let me know what you put inside your potato salad, because I'd really like to know. Right, what breakfast show, if any, do you listen to on the radio? Now, if you listen to my station at Wildlight, you'll have the fantastic Peter Haynes. He's been around for years. He's got a very calming, laid-back approach, and it works. Breakfast time, you don't want need somebody who's right up your backside, shouting and prancing around and playing happy hardcore or trance or anything like that. You want nice relaxing tunes to wake you up slowly into the day. One of our presenters thought that he'd overstepped the mark. Kevin Jackson is on 9 o'clock on a Tuesday. He took over from Peter and he actually said the contrast was completely different. Peter's laid back and calm and he was right in your face. But as I said, 9 o'clock, everybody should be up and you should be wide awake by 9 o'clock. You really should. Can't have you laying in bed. No, definitely not. Have you ever had a telesales from a magazine company offering you six issues of, say, Top Gear for £1? Yeah? Well, I always get them. And I had one from Country Life. You know, the posh magazine, nice houses and flowers and that sort of stuff. Well, I paid the £1 for six issues. No, they kept coming and coming and coming. At the last count, I reckon we've had at least 50 issues. They come out once a week. And bearing in mind, this magazine is £4.50 a week. A lot of money. I can look at the issues now, they're sitting there. We've got about another 30 issues to give away to some lucky person who answers a post on our selling site on Facebook. Free of charge, all you've got to do is pick them up from the front door. Couldn't be easier. What else? Roundabouts. Oh my goodness. Well, as I said, we went shopping the other day, and as you come off to go to Havant, there's a roundabout, very peculiar shape. Not triangle, more like an oval, I think. Would you describe it as an oval? I think she's gone back to bed. I really do. Yeah, it's a weird bend. It's not just your normal roundabout. And how the car stayed on the road, I don't know. Have you experienced any weird roundabouts? I know Milton Keynes is famous for its roundabouts. There's probably about one every two seconds going down the road. Just let me know in the comments, please. Now, I've been speaking again to Joey and Amelia. Now, poor Amelia has got an ear problem with earwax. Now, we told her to use something called Ear Calm. It's basically a spray. You spray it in your, it's one spray in each ear, and it disperses of all the earwax. She's using some drops that she got from Boots. Now, I said to her, why don't you use a cotton bud? And she went, no, they're dangerous. And I'm saying, only if you push them right in. If you're gentle, and after you've had a shower, just wipe the inside of your ear, they'll be fine. Just don't push them too far in. Have you got any tips for Amelia to get rid of this earwax? Because it is hurting her. Well, not hurting, it's more discomfort, and she can't actually hear properly. Which is not bad, because she doesn't know what we're calling her. But any suggestions, please help. Right, well, as I told you, it was payday yesterday, so we thought we'd have a monthly treat, we'd have a Chinese. So we'd realise what we wanted, sweet and sour chicken balls, special fried rice, chips and two pancake rolls. Nothing elaborate. Well, Tracy rings it up. Guess what? Closed. Early closing. Have you still got early closing where you live? Or, I'll say early closing, a day where something doesn't open. I know Gavin over at Ramsey, every day is an early closing day over there because they're so laid back being stuck out in the middle of nowhere. I was absolutely gutted, so I had to have sausage and batter and chips from our chip shop, which was just as nice. Den's the name of our chip shop in the High Street, Selsey. If you're coming to Selsey, call in there, say Gary sent you. I'm not saying you get a freebie, because you won't. But you will get a good deal. At lunchtime, you can get sausages and batter and chips, a beef burger and chips, a small pizza and chips, and a drink for £4.50. You can't go wrong on that, can you, really? Especially if you're on a budget. Right, there's a game that Gavin sent me. Panda Cube Smash. Apparently, you play the game, and for each level, you earn money, which goes into a holding PayPal account, but you can't cash out until you reach $50. Well, I've noticed as the levels get harder, yeah, the money stops coming in. It used to be after every level, you got a reward for PayPal. But when you get to level 50, it goes to every five levels. And it's not dollars, it's cents. So I don't think you're ever going to reach the $50 to be able to cash out. But we will see. That's about it, I think, for today. I will be getting, apparently, I've been telling you I've got stickers and a mug coming. You will be able to get a Gary's Blog pen as well. I found a great deal on the internet to buy them. And if you want to get one, I'll let you know about them when they turn up. But in the meantime, if you want to donate to this channel, you can do paypal.me/ Gary's Blog. Just type that into your browser and you can donate to the channel. Right, whatever you're doing today, make sure you go and check Gavin out at 7 o'clock with Out and About. He will be in. And as I said, HCV Matt, go and have a look at his channel. But whatever you're doing today, you have a good one. But the main thing is, stay safe, and I'll see you tomorrow. Ta-ra.